A serious complication of diabetes is called diabetic ketoacidosis. Do you know the 7 signs and symptoms of this serious complication that leads to death? It's a complication that has the potential to be fatal and kills thousands of diabetics every year. This complication can be avoided as long as you seek help before your condition worsens. Diabetic ketoacidosis is an acute complication of diabetes. Why? Because it happens quickly. Unlike chronic complications such as heart attack or cardiovascular disease, heart damage from high blood sugar can take years to develop. Kidney disease from high blood sugar can also take years to develop. You have time to do tests, identify, and treat these conditions. Diabetic ketoacidosis is an acute complication, so it's a matter of days, sometimes a week, sometimes even 2 weeks. So it's important that even if you've got up-to-date exams, you pay attention to these 7 signs and symptoms to seek help. When I say help, I don't mean scheduling an appointment with the doctor. I mean going straight to the emergency room at the hospital. As I said, we don't have a lot of time in this complication. I specialize in endocrinology and diabetes. I'm going to share some of my knowledge because, unfortunately, diabetic ketoacidosis is still very frequent. Let's go. What are the 7 signs and symptoms? The 7th sign is a lot of thirst and a lot of urine. In medical terms, we call that polydipsia and polyuria. When your blood sugar is too high, your body tries to defend itself and compensate for it in 2 ways. First, your kidneys start to get rid of sugar, start to eliminate glucose. Usually, this mechanism of getting rid of glucose starts to happen when your sugar is higher than 180. So, it's not even that high. It's not even 400, 450. Like I said at the start of the video, greater than 180, this mechanism already starts happening. Another defense mechanism is that our body is stimulated to drink more fluids. You get more thirsty and end up drinking a lot of water in an attempt to counteract this increase in sugar. So, pay attention to the amount of fluids you're consuming per day. If this increases, it could be a sign that your blood sugar is too high and you may have an acute complication from diabetes. Sign number 6. Quick and unexplained weight loss. If you lose more than 10% of your body weight in less than a month, you should already seek emergency care to see what's going on. Of course, if there isn't a reason. If you didn't change your diet, you didn't start exercising, you're simply losing weight and don't know why. Why might this weight loss be happening? But I thought diabetes made you gain weight. When sugar is too high in the blood, there's a change in the hormone insulin. In the case of type 1 diabetes, our body stops producing insulin. It has been attacked by an autoimmune response at the insulin-producing cells in the pancreas, at the beta cells, so you don't have insulin production anymore. What does insulin do? It takes the sugar from the blood and puts it into tissues within the muscles. And since insulin is an anabolic hormone, it causes weight gain. It helps you build muscle mass as well. It has these anabolic functions. If you don't have insulin, you'll lose weight, even if you're eating a lot. One of the triggers, I'll explain at point 6, is weight loss, and you might experience increased hunger, starting in contrast to that. So, weight loss, more than 10% of your weight, is a warning sign. Often, it is ignored. It's not a healthy weight loss, and you should be concerned, and should check your blood sugar levels as soon as possible. Are you finding this video useful? Is it helpful? So I'm asking you to like this video. Let's set a goal of 7,000 likes. Each like is crucial for spreading the content. In this way, the system understands that the video is significant and ends up disseminating this information. We've already acknowledged that this is a serious complication which can even lead to death. If we share this information, we are going to save lives. It's not even a maybe, we're going to save more lives. So help me and like this video, that way you'll be helping other people. And if you're not subscribed here to the channel, I invite you to click on the subscribe button and also activate the notification bell. It puts all the options, that way whenever I post YouTube will send you a notification. You will follow the new videos. Sign number 5, nausea and vomiting. For many years, I attended medical emergencies in the emergency room, and diabetic ketoacidosis, I remember very well that patients came in reporting nausea and vomiting. Why does this happen? For our body to produce energy, since you can't take advantage of the sugar in the blood, you won't have the hormone insulin. Our body starts to produce ketone bodies, And these ketone bodies, what do they cause? Nausea, vomiting can also give abdominal pain. So nausea and vomiting, does that mean that everyone who has nausea, who has vomiting, should go to the emergency room? No. That means you have to associate it with the other signs and symptoms that I'm talking about here. And if you have nausea and vomiting, it's also another sign that is suggestive of diabetic ketoacidosis. So pay attention to that. I'm going to include along number 5, abdominal pain. The patients also report, those who have diabetic ketoacidosis often say that they have pain in the abdomen. And the sign number 4, since I talked about ketone bodies, which are the product of our energy production that doesn't come from glucose, the breath, one way to eliminate ketone bodies is through breathing. Why? When the ketone bodies are in excess in our body, they can intoxicate us. And one of the ways to compensate for that, you're seeing that our whole body is made to try to compensate the increase of sugar in the blood, the increase of ketone bodies, is through breathing, through the breath. So, keto breath. I remember one time when I was in the emergency room, the patient arrived only through breathing. Before speaking with the patient, I could tell just by his breath, which is the ketone breath, I could already formulate the diabetes ketoacidosis hypothesis, and it really confirmed it because it's a very unique kind of breath. So pay attention to changes in your breath, bad breath. This could also be a symptom of diabetes ketoacidosis. And number 3, tiredness, a weakness, that fatigue. You wake up already tired. You were able to sleep, but you wake up tired. Patients report a lack of energy, difficulty in performing daily tasks. Why? Even though you have sugar in your blood, you aren't utilizing that sugar. So your body will become tired. You will be fatigued. This sign of fatigue in patients who have diabetes ketoacidosis, more than 80%, I will refer this sign of weakness. So pay attention. How is your energy? Is your energy levels reduced? Is your battery running low? As many people say, it feels like my battery is running low. I'm waking up tired. Someone once told me, it stuck with me, it's like they put a weight on my legs. You realize it's really hard to carry out normal activities. And the second sign is mental confusion, difficulty thinking, difficulty formulating your ideas in the same way. This sign is also often mentioned. It's very present in patients who have this complication. Your body is undergoing a metabolic change. You can't utilize glucose. This can cause changes in thinking, difficulty concentrating, reduced focus. And the number one sign is a change in breathing, short of breath, heavy breathing, because ketones to try and compensate this. We've already seen that through breathing, the body tries to eliminate these ketones and also by reducing energy. So it's a more serious sign. It's a warning sign. If you have shortness of breath, heavy breathing, there's even a medical term. I don't want to talk about medical terms here because I'm talking to the general population called Kussmaul breathing. This heavy breathing, the shortness of breath, is a pattern very suggestive of diabetic ketoacidosis. From 0 to 10, what grade do you give to this video? If it's 10, I make more videos like that. Now I'm going to leave a suggestion for you to watch. It's a video that I talked about foods that don't raise blood sugar are excellent for those who have diabetes or prediabetes. You click here, you'll be directed to it. A hug. See you next time.